JMU Athletics and the JMU Alumni Association are teaming up to bring you this free MadiZONE HD SportsNet feature presentation. From Harrisonburg, Virginia, and the campus of James Madison University, welcome to NCAA Men's Basketball. Tonight, the James Madison Dukes are at home facing the Spartans of Norfolk State in a state battle. Tonight's game is being presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association, Virginia Lottery, CarMax, Delta Dental, the JMU Graduate School, Intellos Wireless, Old Dominion Realty, Quaker Steak and Lube, Residence Inn, University Outpost, Virginia Blood Services, Virginia 529, Wells Fargo, the JMU Adult Degree Program, Blue Ridge Power Sports, the JMU Bookstore, Klein May Realty, Pepsi, the official soft drink of JMU Athletics, Virginia Business Systems, Comcast SportsNet, and the JMU Duke Club. Well, a very warm welcome, everyone, on a very chilly night here in Harrisonburg. I'm Kurt Dudley. Joining me tonight for in-game commentary is one Miss Nikki Newman. As we are set for tonight's ball game, the final game here at the Convocation Center before Christmas, and just a few days away. But the Dukes, well, they're smarting just a bit, Nikki, after they dropped an 80-71 decision here on Saturday. And for the Dukes, only their second loss at home this season in 8 tries.
That's right, Kurt. The best start they've had at home in 4 years to this date. And they're playing a single season record of 19 home games this season. They certainly haven't disappointed the hometown fans. They have a 6-2 record at home right now at the Convocation Center. 5 of those 6 games, Madison trailed early against their opponents and had a rally back. As many as 8 points against Radford and 11 points in their win against Campbell on December 2nd. Last time out, though, JMU saw its 6-game home win streak end as High Point used a 10-0 run in the second half to win 80-71. And that was last Saturday at the Convo. John Brown scored 24 points off the bench for High Point as they shot 50% to earn the win road.
Well, the Norfolk State Spartans, they're coming in with, quite a bit of confidence. They're 8-5 overall, and they'll face this 7-4 JMU team. Their last outing was at home, and they're beginning a 6-game road trip today as they face the Dukes here in Harrisonburg. Their last outing was on Friday night, and they defeated Northern Arizona 81-62. Jeff Short and Rashid Gaston, they again reached the 20-point milestone, leading Norfolk State to the 81-62 win, and that was at Joseph Eccles Hall. Short scored a game-high 25 points, while Gaston added 20 and grabbed 11 rebounds. Norfolk State outscored the Lumberjacks by 18 points in the first half, on way to shooting 57% overall for the game, 27-47 on field goal attempts. The Spartans also connected on 7-15 from long range, and Deshaun Taylor added 13 points, while Malik Thomas totaled 8 points and 11 rebounds. As we take a look at this matchup, let's take a look at how these two teams stack up against one another from a statistical standpoint. But one thing that Coach Matt Brady was very impressed with, not only some of the scoring numbers of the individuals, as we'll get to, but also the overall shooting percentages of these two teams, particularly with Norfolk State coming in very strong at 46% on field goals. You see both teams with a bit of a plus on the rebounding category. But Nikki, the Spartans, the one thing that really stands out about them, like the Dukes, they have very balanced scoring, although it tapers off. Actually, it drops off pretty abruptly, whereas the Dukes kind of tapers off throughout the lineup.
That's definitely the thing. For Norfolk State, they have 4 players averaging double-digit performances right now. Deshaun Taylor averaging 13.1 points a game, Jeff Short 18 points a game, Malik Thomas with 11 points a game, and Rashid Gaston with 15 points a game. And after that, they don't have much production from their bench, a majority of them only averaging 2 points a game.
Whereas the Dukes, they've got a handful of players right there just above double digits. Let's take a look at the top players coming into today. You see Jackson Kent, who on his birthday tied his career high with 18 points here in the loss on Saturday. He is the leading scorer. Andre Nation just a shade below 10 points per game. The Dukes also getting a little over 10 points a game out of Johanny Dallenberg. Jeff Short, he is an impressive figure, 18.5 points per game, and that number actually has been on the climb. Last several games, he's been putting 20 points or more up on the board. And Rashid Gaston, we told you he had a good game on Friday night. Well, he expects to have a pretty good game again here tonight. The 6'9 junior, a good numbers all the way across the board. 16 points and 10 rebounds per game nearly. And look at his shooting at 60% per contest. So it's the Dukes and the Spartans. The third time these two programs have met one another. The Dukes, they've won the both the previous matchups. And we'll come back and get you set for tonight's ball game between the Dukes and the Spartans after this brief timeout here on MadiZONE HD SportsNet, presented by the JMU Alumni Association.
Instead of asking yourself, where did those 4 years go? Think about where the next 40 will take you. Be involved at Madison. Dukes from day one, alumni for life.
Visit the James Madison University Bookstore, your source for all things JMU. Get your official Duke gear. Open after every football game. The JMU Bookstore. Support the team.
Introducing something new from Old Dominion. Our clients have loved our feature-rich mobile site for years, and now you can get all that info in an app. Search the way you like. Discover listings in new ways. From desktop to mobile, we've got you covered. And one more thing, we are the only company in the area to have access to 5 MLS systems. That means you'll get more listings and info here than anywhere else. Guaranteed. Old Dominion Realty. Now that's what you are looking for.
Welcome back to the JMU Convocation Center. Kurt Dudley, Nikki Newman with you here tonight, bringing you men's college basketball action. It's a busy day for teams around the Colonial Athletic Association. Elon already has posted a win, beating Kennesaw State 67-65. In addition to the Dukes hosting Norfolk State this evening, Delaware on the road at Robert Morris. Blue Hens still looking for a win. Towson visits Navy. William and Mary went across the Hampton Roads Bridge Tunnel and is playing at Old Dominion tonight. Northeastern at St. Mary's. That's the St. Mary's out in California. There are several of them across the country. And the College of Charleston is in Baton Rouge to face the Tigers of Louisiana, LSU, Louisiana State. Let's take a look at the overall standings to date. Now, of course, no conference games have been played yet, but look at the overall records, and you have to get all the way down to Drexel before you see a losing mark in the Colonial. That's good news. Earlier today at O'Neill's Grill here in Harrisonburg, Matt Brady was asked what he thinks about the league overall, and he thought it was doing very well, except a few losses this past week where the programs had chances to win, and JMU would be considered one of those with the loss to High Point. Hofstra had a difficult loss to Columbia. That was quite a surprise, quite frankly. Northeastern's done very well out on the West Coast. They're playing their third game out there since they flew out midweek last week. And Towson certainly, JMU at 7-4, so some good early numbers for some of the Colonial Athletic Association teams. We're just a little over, well, just a little over 2 weeks away before we start Colonial Athletic Association play. Actually, less than 2 weeks away. It won't be this weekend, but the following weekend. And the Dukes will open up at home against the Towson Tigers coming up here on January the 3rd. There's a look at Ron Curry. Curry tried to bounce back from a subpar scoring night here on Saturday. He did have 8 assists in the ball game, but he had a great game against Ball State, really controlled the game there, but didn't have quite the ball game he wanted on Saturday. We're looking for him to have a bounce back game here tonight. Now it's time for our national anthem, presented to you by the JMU Pep Band. I see that President Alger and the family are in the house tonight to watch the Dukes play a little basketball against Norfolk State. Let's take a look at our starting lineups first of all. For the visitors from Norfolk State, again coming in with a record of 8-5. And let's take a look at that starting lineup. Robert Jones, the head coach, more on him in just a moment. And a redshirt senior will start as 6'4", Jamel Fuentes out of Brooklyn, New York, 2.9 points per game, 2.7 rebounds per contest. Deshaun Taylor is a 6'5 junior from Nassau, Bahamas by way of Garden City Community College and John Brown University, 13.1 points, 4.5 rebounds. Jeff Short, the leading scorer, 18.5 points per game, 4.1 rebounds, a 6'4 redshirt junior from the Bronx, New York. Malik Thomas, a 6'7 redshirt senior from Harlem, New York, by way of Boston University, 11.7 points, 5.8 rebounds. And Rashid Gaston, a 6'9 junior, Warren, Ohio, Warren G. Harding High School, 15.7 points, 9.6 rebounds per contest. Again, Robert Jones is the head coach, graduate of New Paltz in New York, 2002 graduate. His record, 27 wins and 20 losses, again in his second season. Now let's move on to the Dukes of James Madison. You see them all sitting on the bench there. And first of all, Yohani D'Alembert, a 6'8 sophomore from Port-au-Prince, Haiti, by way of Laura Marion High School, the same high school where one Kobe Bryant played. 10.4 points per game, 5.6 rebounds. Paulus Shotka starts tonight, a 6'8 sophomore out of Lithuania by way of Barking Abbey in England. Ron Curry, a 6'4 junior from Pennsauken, New Jersey, from Paul VI, 9.7 points, 4 rebounds, 4.9 assists per game. Winston Gray's a 6'2 junior from Cleveland, Ohio, by way of Cincinnati State, just under 10 points a game. And Jackson Kent, 6'7 sophomore from High Point, North Carolina. And Jackson averaging 11.5 points per game, 4.5 rebounds per contest. Matt Brady in his seventh season as the head coach of the Dukes of James Madison. His record, 106 wins and 106 losses. He's in his 11th season overall, 179 wins, 156 losses. And he led the Dukes to the CAA championship a couple of years back and to the first tournament win in the NCAA, dating back to the early 1980s. Your officials for today's ball game, Paul Fa, Billy Humes, and Gary Duda. That's the officiating crew here this evening. There's Billy Humes right there. So a veteran crew here on this Monday night. Well, Dukes, they came out, Nikki, in gold uniforms, but they had to make a wardrobe change.
I believe that's right. Norfolk State is in their yellow uniforms with the green, so I guess they had to go back up and put the white on.
We would have had a lot of blending together had the Dukes worn their gold with the yellow. Yohani D'Alembert will jump up, and the Dukes will win the opening tap, which has been a rare occasion. And he was jumping up with Rashid Gaston, so the Dukes had some difficulty against the zone the other night, but Norfolk State will open up in the man-to-man defensively here for the visitors from Norfolk, Virginia. Winston Grays gives it up to D'Alembert. Grays again, he'll penetrate, leaves it for Yohani, kicks it out in the corner, around the perimeter it goes. Curry will pivot, gets it down low, and Paulius Shotkus, I think he was surprised he was open there, Nikki.
Very wide open, and you know, great pass there by Ron. Great ball movement by the Dukes for that first possession.
Well, considering how sluggish they were in ball movement here on Saturday, I think that was probably a big emphasis in practice yesterday. Here's Short, long range. Three-pointer is good for Jeff Short, so he can hit the tray. That is his 31st of the season on 71 attempts, a 43% shooter from beyond the arc.
And definitely somebody that the Dukes are going to have to keep an eye out for. He's the one who averages 18 points a game for the Spartans.
Ball is blocked as Kent went up. It's knocked away by Malik Thomas. Thomas comes down into the corner. Short draws the attention of D'Alembert, back out to Thomas. Norfolk State whips it around. Short, long range shot, and it's another three-pointer for Jeff Short. He's 2-for-2, And he has given Norfolk State the early 6-2 lead, and the Dukes facing a little pressure. They break the pressure. Here's Jackson Kenny, double dribbles. And a quick substitution will come in as Paulius Vignogradovas comes in. He is the Lithuanian, just averages 0.4 points and 1.1 rebounds per game. That's an interesting early substitution.
Very early, and you saw right there on the replay, Jackson, good idea to get the ball up to Johanny and just picked it up a little bit too early.
Dukes, one thing that Madison has done is spoiled a lot of pretty easy opportunities, I think, is one of the issues that Madison has had thus far in the first 11 games of the season. We'll see our first foul call tonight, and Malik Thomas will pick that up. That is his first personal, and the team's first personal foul as well. Dukes will have the inbound as Billy Humes will hand it over to Paulius Shotkus. So we got a couple of Lithuanians in the ball game, one for each squad. Not sure if the two talked before the ball game. Looks like Paulius has got a haircut since the last game. So is Amy Spring. There's the layup, and the Shotkus finds himself all alone once again. He's got all of four for JMU, while it's short with all six for Norfolk State. The Spartans from the Mideastern Athletic Conference picked to finish fourth in the 13-team league this year. They split it up to try to cut some of the travel costs. The conference up and down the East Coast goes all the way down to Florida, a couple of teams there. In fact, part of their six-game road trip for Norfolk State will be playing the two MEAC schools in the Sunshine State. First rebound for Johanny Dallenbear. Gray's skip pass comes out. Here's Ron Curry. Curry leaves it for Dallenbear. See ya, slam it home.
Very interesting, whatever type of defense Norfolk State is running, because, you know, the three possessions that JMU has scored, it's been wide open layups down in the paint.
Interesting so much that Robert Jones says, I want to time out and talk about what the heck is going on defensively as the Dukes, they're getting some high percentage shots because, well, they're just like that one. Those are the kind of shots you like to get, right? Right,
yeah.
Underneath the bucket.
The wide open ones.
The wide open
ones. The best ones.
Although you did become a three-point shooter as your career got a little later. Now, I don't know if you've seen this tweet. I found this tweet a little funny here, Nikki. Lady Swish says, it's almost as though she used to play or something, since you're on the broadcast.
Maybe
here
just
with
a
us
little
today.
Bit.
We have all kinds of dignitaries here tonight. We're going to talk with one Kirby Burkholder, who is in attendance here this evening. I haven't seen her yet. Have you spotted her?
Just oh, walked
there
in.
She is. She's walking down the aisle now. She seems to have that European look to her right now. And we also have in the house one Pierre Curtis, former point guard for the JMU men's basketball Dukes, played in more games than any other player in JMU men's basketball history. Here's Fuentes. He'll give it up now to Thomas. Thomas with a handoff to Short. He dribbles and loses the handle, out of bounds. Last touch by Short. Short out of the Bronx, New York, went to John F. Kennedy High School, then went to Fordham. This team has only one member of its roster from the Commonwealth of Virginia. They have six transfers to the Spartans, one player from Lithuania and one from China. Quite the mix. There's the ball movement against the zone. And Dukes can't handle the passing down low. They did get the ball. One thing they didn't do the other day was against that 3-2, did not work the high-low post, and which was kind of a shock because the Dukes had been very successful in that, facing the zone in earlier ball games. Fuentes will bring it up. He's from Brooklyn, New York, but went to an academy in New Jersey. The jumper is good. And count that for Deshaun Taylor, an average of 13.1 points per game. Norfolk State out in front, 8-6. Well, the pace was real fast at first. It's kind of settled in now as we move to the fifth minute of the contest. Down low, double team, Shotkus. Here's the corner. Graves is open. Winston a little short, and a foul on the floor as Polyashotkis is fouled by Jeff Short. Short just a little out of control. Shotkus, I think he expected a little different altitude from Shotkus, and he didn't get it. Timeout on the floor, our first media timeout for you here at the Convocation Center. Norfolk State with the early lead, 8-6. You're watching JMU Men's Basketball on MadiZONE HD SportsNet, presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association.
I knew going to JMU would be more about just getting a master's.
I just knew that it was the place for me.
I feel as though that I'm a part of the institution.
You will never meet a stranger. Everyone is always willing to help you out and to help you through your graduate experience here at James Madison University.
The graduate school here is a great choice.
The education that you receive is top notch.
It's one of the best in the country. And from here, everything is possible.
Norfolk State with the lead. Pepsi, it is the official soft drink of JMU Athletics. Pepsi, a fine sponsor of JMU Sports. The last time these two teams played, it was right here in Harrisonburg on December the 2nd, 2009. I mentioned earlier Pierre Curtis. Curtis played in that game. He led five Dukes in double figures, finishing with 17 points. He also reached a career milestone that night. He became the 24th player in JMU men's basketball history to reach 1,000 career points. The Dukes do lead this series 2-0. That final score back in 2009, JMU 72 and Norfolk State 64. And that was a fourth consecutive win for the Dukes after starting the year with two consecutive losses. We had a foul on the floor, and that was against Short. So two fouls against Norfolk State. The Dukes have yet to commit any violations. Here's Jackson Kent on the jump pass from Ron Curry, and count that. Jackson Kent now with 24 three-pointers. That ties the number that he hit as a freshman. He had 24 a year ago, so he is on his way to a career high this season. Get a hand check out front. First foul of the Dukes goes against Ron Curry. See a couple of subs come in, a couple of true freshmen. Number four, Joey McLean from High Point, North Carolina. Went to High Point Christian with Jackson Kent. And the rookie of the week in the Colonial, number 25, Harry Hall out of Florida by way of Chicago. So he likes both climates, cold and warm. Whoops, pretty close to a travel. Out top there was Gaston. Here's Short, gets around D'Alembert. Saw a little difficulty there, and close quarters on the far side. Norfolk State fortunate to hang on to the basketball. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Here's a drive, Fuentes. Off the glass, no good. Good positioning. The putback will not fall. Rebound by Glass. By Fuentes, excuse me. And a foul on JMU's Joy McLean.
I believe that'll be a big thing for the Dukes tonight, is staying on the boards. You know, Norfolk State is a team who averages or out-rebounds other teams by 6 a game. So definitely something the Dukes should concentrate on tonight.
Dukes just did win the rebounding battle against High Point by 1 here on Saturday. Andre Nation now in the lineup. He is the defender on Short, as the Dukes now trail 11-9 after that three-pointer from the corner. And that one dropped in by Deshaun Taylor. That's his 23rd three-pointer of the year. He has 5 points this evening. McLean, as again Norfolk State in the zone. Dukes with good ball movement. Baseline jumper by Harry Hall. Off the mark, Short comes down with a rebound. He'll give it up. Fuentes, the skip pass right side, three-pointer. Well off the mark. Jackson Kent grabs the rebound, hard off the glass. Kent into the forecourt, finds McLean. And ball is kicked, so that'll stop the clock. And in the lineup, Latre Russell, a 6'6 senior from Chicago, Illinois. Went to a community college in Des Moines. Yohani D'Alembert with a tough shot. Rebound ripped down by Gaston. Here's Taylor. He steps into a three. It's off the front of the rim. Rebound. D'Alembert off to Hall. Hall will survey. Now he'll wait for McLean to come up and take the basketball from him. Nation, McLean, round the corner it goes. Jackson Kent, three-pointer. Count it. Teammate to teammate. There it is, number 25 for Jackson Kent. And that gives him a new career high.
You can see on the offensive end right now, the Dukes are getting a lot of looks that they want to get just by moving the ball around, especially it's kind of a stagnant zone that Norfolk State is playing.
Second foul, though, on McLean. Yohani D'Alembert will take a breather as Paulius Schottkitz comes back in for the Dukes. In the corner, it's short. Nation jumped past him, looking for the screen. McLean jumps into another screen. Taylor got away with a little illegal screen there, gave him some shoulder. Short gets up, elevates, and drops it in.
Really good defense originally by JMU, just moving around, picking up each other's guys, and just, you know, Hari Hall maybe could have come out and contested that shot a little bit quicker.
Another three-pointer for Jackson Kent. His five three-pointers here on Saturday was a single game high. Taylor bumps with Kent. Kent can't get the foul, but he does disrupt the shot, and the Dukes will come back with a rebound. McLean gets by his man, tries to go up and under, and eventually out of bounds, last touch by Norfolk State. Winston Graves will report back in for Jackson Kent. And Malik Thomas back in for the visitors from Norfolk State as Deshaun Taylor goes to the bench. Andre Nation, haven't heard much from him quite yet. Andre getting a little better with that big toe that he injured a couple of games ago. I didn't see any sign of it bothering him on Saturday. So he gets through this game. He's got another week to play. Leaving it for Nation, and he's going to boot it out of bounds. Dukes were trying to get Nation to go to the baseline, and McLean wanted to leave it there for him, but he left it right at his feet. So the big toe got in the way, I think. Dukes with a 15-13 lead. We've exchanged the lead a couple of times. Double team. Dukes can't come up with it. This results in numbers for Norfolk State and the slam home for Rashid Gaston. He ties us up at 15 all. Norfolk State gone back into the man, Nikki.
They have, and you saw in the first couple possessions when they went man, you know, a lot of the times they used the screen, and Jamie was able to get a lot of open looks on that.
Hari Hall takes one from the top of the circle. Here's Short, looked like he was going to settle in. Now he'll kick it back out. Short likes to work from this left wing. That's where he's hit his couple of shots. He has 8 points. Driving down Fuentes. On the turn. What was the call? We got a.
I believe they called an offensive foul.
They did. And it was called against Latre Russell, his first. Team foul number 3. Timeout on the floor. We're tied at 15 all at our second media timeout. Here on MadiZone HD SportsNet, presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association.
Of other tempting things. Great times, great food. Get to Quaker Steak and Lube.
Get saucy at Quaker Steak and Lube. Feel the heat with new Sriracha Chicken Tacos, Island Jerk Chicken Sandwich, or Sweet Heat Curry Chicken Wrap. Now for a limited time.
Great times, great food. Get
too quick to steak and lube.
Introducing something new from Old Dominion. Our clients have loved our feature-rich mobile site for years, and now you can get all that info in an app. Search the way you like. Discover listings in new ways. From desktop to mobile, we've got you covered. And one more thing, we are the only company in the area to have access to 5 MLS systems. That means you'll get more listings and info here than anywhere else. Guaranteed. Old Dominion Realty. Now that's what you were looking for.
The Residence Inn by Marriott provides guests with plenty of room. Room to recharge. Room to prepare. Room to relax. Stay one night or as long as you like. The Residence Inn by Marriott provides each guest with amenities tailored to their individual needs. Spacious suites with all the comforts of home. Because it's not just a room, it's a residence.
Well, Jackson Kent, 5 three-pointers here on Saturday in the loss. He's already up to 3 three-pointers in this ball game, so 8 in the last 2 contests. Good news for Jackson on Saturday was that he got he was scoring in both halves. There's been a situation where he will put up good points in the first half, get shut out in the second. Well, he finished with the 18 points here on Saturday, and now with the 3 tonight. That gives him 26 three-pointers on the season. Again, 2 more than what he had all of last year. There's a newcomer into the lineup now. Zanai Robinson, a 5'11 freshman from Duluth, Georgia. He has it in his possession now. And Curry will harass him. Short has Winston Graves. Graves going underneath the screen. Short with a ball fake. Thomas, shot clock down to 4. Robinson, and we get a travel as the defense out front creates the shot clock violation.
The Dukes have been really playing solid defense in this first half so far in the first 10 minutes of the game. And we've seen a couple of the shots that Norfolk State has been getting has been, you know, when the shot clock's down to 5 seconds, 3 seconds.
Curry will take the inbounds from Ivan Lukic, who has checked in for the Dukes. Ivan, a 6'8 sophomore out of Serbia. Spent time at ABCD Academy in Iowa. I wonder if they have a sister school, 1-2-3-4 Academy. Here's Curry, trying to break it down. Takes the shot, it's gonna be well short. And the rebound ripped in by Gaston. Down the floor it goes, Short will score it. Short, first player into double figures, he has 10. They go the other way, ball knocked out of bounds. Jackson Kent will come back in, Andre Nation. Kind of a quiet session there, although I think he played pretty good defense, although didn't create a couple of turnovers or anything, but certainly was in his deniability stage. And Curry will make it to the rim. Looked like the rim rattled there after the net was grabbed. Looking for a goaltending call. It will not happen, though. Robinson trying to spin against Curry. One number two guarding the other. Lukic may have got a hand on it. Let's take a look at it again. Here's, well, it, I think the timing might have been okay. JMU foul this time. Called against Lukic, his first. Team foul number 4. Inbounds comes into Latre Russell. Dukes have missed their last 5 shots, 2 of their last 9. And dropped in Gaston has his second field goal. He averages just under 16 a game. Norfolk State on a little run here as they've taken the four-point lead. D'Alembert.
The last time the Dukes scored was off of Jackson Kent's three-pointer. He's had the last 9 points that the Dukes have.
Gets tangled up there, finds Curry. Curry from the right wing. That's a three-pointer. Ron is on the board for the first time since last Wednesday as he was shut out. Had a difficult night shooting, 0 for 11. Now, some of those were late-game shots as the Dukes were in desperation mode. Again, he did have 8 assists on the evening. Even John Wall struggled to shoot the ball last night for Washington, but he had a good number of assists. Winston Graves runs into Robinson, who'll get called for the foul. And timeout on the floor, 7:44 remaining in the first. Norfolk State with the slight advantage, 19-18 here on MadiZone HD SportsNet, presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association.
The Residence Inn by Marriott provides guests with plenty of room. Room to recharge. Room to prepare. Room to relax. Stay one night or as long as you like. The Residence Inn by Marriott provides each guest with amenities tailored to their individual needs. Spacious suites with all the comforts of home. Because it's not just a room, it's a residence.
Welcome back to the JMU Convocation Center. Kurt Dudley and Nikki Newman with you here tonight. Well, the JMU Alumni Association's monthly e-newsletter, you can sign up for it. We'll have another edition coming out the first of the new year. Sign up today at alumni.jmu.edu/MadisonUpdates. Any numbers that kind of jump out at you there, Nikki, on our third media timeout?
And Jackson Kent, like we said earlier, shooting 3 from 3 from behind the arc right now with 9 points, leading the Dukes. Paulus with 4 points. Ron Curry, you just saw there in that replay a little bit ago, his first three-pointer of the game. And for Norfolk State, still Jeff Short with 10 points, shooting 2 from 2 from three-pointer and 4 from 5 from the field.
7:44 to go. Again, join us at intermission. Nikki Sidekick is going to join us here, as although Nikki has missed her like many of us have, as Kirby Burkholder earning her dollars in Italy, playing professionally. And we'll get a little bit of insight there here at halftime. Foul out on the drive. Malik Gray, his first personal. Gray, a product of Fort Union Military Academy. He's the only Virginian on the roster out of Newport News. That's the 5th team foul. Zone defense. Curry leaves it. D'Alembert up and under and good.
Once again, you saw, you talked about it a little bit earlier, when the Dukes get the ball to the high post, it seems like there's a lot of openings down on the block for easy looks at the basket.
Blind pass by Short. And he's looked like it was deflected by one of the Dukes, however, as Madison recaptures the lead. There have been now 8 lead changes in this ball game, and a foul out front.
Seen a lot of on-ball touch fouls called so far in this first half. You saw right there from Ron Curry, not too much contact, but enough to draw a foul.
Well, Curry's got 2 fouls, and his replacement, Joy McLean's got 2 fouls. So at the moment, you take the lesser of the two evils, and that's go with the youngster, McLean, running with the 2. Short, in and out. Lots of bodies on the floor. The foul is going to be against Norfolk State. as Rashid Gaston is whistled for the first time tonight. Curry on the bench, being chatted to by Mike Dean. Curry with four assists already. His season average 4.9. That's a travel on D'Alembert. Yes. Virginia Tech leading VMI in men's basketball tonight, 27-15. Oh, that's a tough break there. That is three now on McLean. Well, this presents a dilemma for Coach Brady. Now, McLean missed seven games because of a foot injury. He might miss some additional playing time in this game if he picks up another one. And he can't afford, with Ron Curry on the bench with two fouls, just to bring him in right away. They may have to weather the storm here the rest of this half. Battle for the loose basketball. McLean saves it, gets it into the hands of Kent, and he is fouled by Deshaun Taylor. Taylor's first. And this will put the Dukes at the free throw line. A 101 for Jackson Kent, who can become the first Duke in double figures if he hits the front end here. Jackson 28-36 on the year, 78%. That's the Duke's first free throw tonight. And he's 2 for 2.
I don't think Jackson's eighth game in double figures so far this season, 17th for his career.
Well, he's had already a good first half, so we'll keep an eye on what he does in the second half as well. Some contact by Short, misses, rebound, Hari Hall. Off to McLean. McLean down the floor, draws some contact. Oh, McLean got crunched down below. Numbers now for Norfolk State. Fuentes leaves it, and the slam for Gaston, and a technical foul afterwards for hanging up on the rim. Count the bucket. So Jackson Kent will go to the free throw line for the technical. So in the eyes of the officials, hanging on to the rim was not necessary to protect him. You can do so if there are bodies underneath you, but if you do it in a what can be considered, judged, in an unsportsmanlike manner, they can call the foul. You ever been called for one like that, Nikki?
I can't say one like that.
Oh, okay.
I wish for that reason, but no. Well,
I wouldn't have you sitting with me if you did that, right?
Very, very true.
24-21, Dukes with the lead. D'Alembert kicks it back out, McLean. Winston Graves, long distance tray. That's 12 for him this season. Ball loose. Kent will leave it. McLean, three-pointer. Rims the cup and slammed back in by Johanny D'Alembert.
Good job there by the Dukes just to get back on that transition break. Joey pulled up for the three, and for Johanny to be there and throw it down like that.
The yo-yo on the go there. Bingo. And the Dukes up 29-21. 5:14 to go. You didn't know that you were with a stand-up comedy routine, did you? Timeout was called by Norfolk State. Robert Jones, again in his second season, 27 wins, 20 losses. You know, from the eye test, Nikki and I talked about this when we first came into the arena tonight. Now, it has been a number of years since I've seen Norfolk State, but I grew up in Norfolk, actually went to high school right across the street from Norfolk State. And this is one of, physically, just the eye test, this is one of the best looking teams in terms of basketball bodies.
They definitely are a very athletic looking group of guys.
Big, a lot of times you'll see some of the MEACs don't have player for player the size that Norfolk State has. A nice size move inside. Jordan Butler scoring the basket. 29-23. Jackson Kent already has three trays to his credit today. Leads the Dukes with 13 points. Ari Hall goes in strong. Rebound, though, nicely done as Butler boxed out well. Fuentes around the corner uses the big screen by the Butler. Here's Short on this side. The drive goes up against D'Alembert, who defends well and then rips down the basketball and controls it from there. Down the floor it goes in a hurry to Winston Graves. Graves back to McLean. McLean again playing with three fouls. So his aggression tempered a bit because of that, obviously. Spin move for Jackson Kent. Goes to Graves, and he steps into the short jumper. Good recognition. That looked like a Nicky Newman assist right there.
That's the thing. It looks like the Dukes are really getting a lot of the shots that they want to get right now, and especially in this first half.
They're calling a foul on McLean coming around the corner. Let's see that again. I hope we can. This will take us to a one-and-one situation when we come back. 3:35 to play. And hopefully when we come back from this break, we'll have a chance to take a look at that again. I'm not sure if it was McLean that he tripped over. Fans behind us think it was his own teammates. Let's see here. Indeed it was. He tripped over his own man.
Definitely a tough call, too, because that's the fourth on Joey now.
That is the fourth, absolutely. Here you see it again. Timeout on the floor. JMU with a 31-23 lead, but they got some foul problems for the point guards. We'll be back with more after this timeout on MadiZone HD SportsNet, presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association.
Now with a full line of independent rear suspension options, the all-new Foreman Rubicon and Rancher Automatic DCT models are equally ready to work and have fun. Part of the growing ATV family from Honda.
Blue Ridge Power Sports, where the power is yours.
I think Joel took one up. There he is. He's going to get a hazard pay tonight from John Salem. Joel Taylor on the baseline with the camera. An unfortunate call against the Dukes. Going to the free throw line. Well, that's a nice design play. If you can get a foul called against your teammate, trip over your own dude.
Definitely say so.
So puts Fuentes at the free throw line. And he'll hit the front end. Jamel Fuentes in the scorebook now. He's a 75% free throw shooter now. 16 of 21, so he improves that average a bit. Jogging in will be Malik Gray. And Gray, the only player from Virginia on the roster. Second shot, no good. Rebound, Andre Nation. Nation comes back in. He may be running a little point guard here for the remainder of the half. Knocked out. Looks like Robinson's going to check back in. Averages 2.1 points, just over an assist per game. Shotka's back in for the Dukes. Now Nation directing some traffic. He's asking Hari Hall to come up high. He's in the keyhole to Graves. Dukes may just chew up some clock here against this zone also. Trying to neutralize these fouls. Jumper for Andre Nation is good, and that's a tray.
Good opportunity right here for the Dukes to get a stop on the defensive end and push this lead out a little bit more.
Out to 10 after that three-pointer for Andre Nation, his first bucket of the night. He has now hit 3 three-pointers on the season, 3 for 15. Hari Hall comes out. Hall again, the rookie of the week in the CAA. Wild shot and rebound, fought for. One and strong move by Jordan Butler, the freshman from Hartford, Connecticut. That is his second.
A player who's capable of putting up points. His career high was 12 points against UVA Wise.
Ken on the right wing. He's got the height advantage. He can shoot over him if he cares to. Bad pass from Shotkus. Russell will come back in for Norfolk State. Looks like Dallenbear will report back into the court or into the action for JMU as well. Robinson. Butler has it picked. Let's see how the toe is. We're not going to find that one out.
Looks like the whole time. Never seemed like he really had complete control of the basketball that time.
He needed some sticky fingers there. It just didn't quite work for him.
Maybe got a little bit too excited at such a wide open basket there.
You want to be quick, but sometimes not too fast. Always get that confused. Do you want to be quick or fast? Or fast or quick? Fast but not quick, quick but not fast. Short. Here's Robinson. Short will try it. Off the iron, no good. He was hot early, but he has calmed down.
Yeah, so with only 10 points, the Dukes have done a really good job on him, not letting him get an open look at the basket.
He had his first two shots. They were both three-pointers. Gave Norfolk State the early 6-2 advantage. Actually, 6-0 advantage. And Dallenbear is fouled as they get the ball inside. Russell picking up his second. Russell just swiping at it, and that is the team eighth foul. Dallenbear at the free throw line. One and one. Gray comes up with a carom. Short, elevates, again off the rim. Ball blocked, they're gonna call a foul on the Dukes. Winston Graves. Get a good look at it here. Well, you probably could have taken your pick on that one. Graves or Dallenbear both got a lot of the arm. Well, Russell goes to the free throw line, 8 of 11. Drops in the first. Dukes had a 10-point lead. Norfolk State has chipped away at a bit. Lukic will come back in. Hari Hall will take a seat. So Sid Hari, this week's CA Player of the Week. Coach Brady praiseful of his willingness to learn. He said the biggest thing with Hari is just controlling his emotion in the game itself.
You can definitely tell with that. He's a player who plays with a lot of energy before the plays, after the plays.
A good example of him playing with his emotion. Duke's had a big lead at Ball State on Wednesday. He slammed the ball in, was fouled, and turned around and got in the guy's face and drew a technical foul. Now, it was not costly, and you might find that it will end up being a good learning experience without being very detrimental to the Dukes in that game. In fact, Coach Brady with the Dukes with a substantial lead, he had him play the last 6 minutes of the game just to give him more live experience. Third foul called now against Russell. D'Alembert missing back-to-back free throws. Johanny, a 74% shooter. Dukes haven't scored for 2:35 now. Missing again. Lukic is fouled as he taps the ball to himself.
The Dukes have done a pretty good job on the board so far in this game. Only 13 rebounds right now, 9 defensive rebounds and 4 offensive rebounds, but really making an effort to crash the boards.
Meanwhile, Norfolk State with 15 boards. Well, Dukes, isn't this the convocation center of James Madison? Dukes missing all these free throws on the home court. Another one missed by the Dukes. Drought lasts a little longer. Fuentes looking to get short as Nation is on him. Fuentes fills the gap that was left void by Short. Lukic with the rebound. Trying to get it out to Graves. It's like a quarterback. Graves will flip it up off the heel of the rim. Nearly had a magical shot tumble home. But it does come up just short. Well, the Dukes out in front, 34-28. Lukic, take a look at that final play. Looked like Lukic was a quarterback at one time as he led the pass over the top. 34-28 here at the JMU Convocation Center. A couple of things to get your way. First of all, you do have a chance to join us here at halftime. We're going to have a special guest come our way if we can find her. I know she's here somewhere. And we'll get Kirby Burkholder here just a little bit. Also want to give you the email address that you can write us here this evening. Always enjoy hearing from folks. If you've got a holiday message you want to share with JMU fans and friends, you can do so. If you're a fan of the Norfolk State Spartans, wouldn't mind hearing from you as well. Like to know where you might be watching from, who you may be rooting for here this evening, whether you're a fan of the Dukes or a fan of the Spartans of Norfolk State. Of course, it is the holiday season as well, and with that, we're going to send you to this very special holiday message from JMU Athletics.
This holiday season,
we want to say,
from our family
to yours,
happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Feine feestdagen.
Happy holidays.
And a happy new year.
And thank you
for all of your support.
For everything you do.
Knowing you're behind us,
we can't thank you enough.
Go Dukes.
Go Dukes.
Go Dukes.
Go Dukes.
Go Dukes.
On behalf of JMU Athletics, we wish you the very best this holiday season. And go Dukes.
Go on too many dates.
all know the importance of continuing your education, whether completing a degree or seeking professional development. Are you thinking about your next step? JMU's adult degree program is designed to create opportunities for adults to pursue an undergrad degree that fits their lifestyle. If completing your degree is something you've been wanting to do, JMU Outreach and Engagement can help you achieve your goal. Call today to learn more. Whatever your next step, JMU Outreach and Engagement is with you every step of the way.
Telos wants to give you more for the holidays, like 2 gigs of data and unlimited talk and text for just $25 a month. That's a better value than Verizon and AT&T. And nothing says happy holidays like getting the smartphone you want for zero down. And Telos will even buy out your contract. It's $25, 2 gigs of data, and unlimited talk and text. Happier holidays from Entelos. More phones, more lines, more data. Get more for the holidays from Entelos.
Welcome back to the JMU Convocation Center. The Dukes are leading the Spartans of Norfolk State 34-28. Kurt Dudley, Nikki Newman with you right now. But actually, Nikki has, well, she's taken a seat down the front row here a little bit because we've got a special guest for you. Welcome back to the United States. This is our international player now. My neighbor, got to watch this girl grow up and then play a little basketball for Kenny Brooks and the Dukes of James Madison, the CA offensive, CA player of the year. Kirby Burkholder, welcome back home. I know you have a little jet lag right now, right?
A little bit, yeah. It's about 2 o'clock in Italy.
2 o'clock a.m.
Yeah.
Yeah, a.m. So we're in the middle of the night here in Harrisonburg. But welcome back. I want to talk a little bit about, well, the experience, first of all, of going over to Italy. Now, I keep up with you on Facebook. I know a lot of JMU Nation fans do as well. But what's the experience been like just to be there around the Mediterranean, you know, at this stage of your life?
It's been definitely an experience. It's been really good in the aspect of seeing Italy. I mean, not a lot of people get the chance to do that in the off day. You know, I've seen all parts of Italy, and it's amazing. And just have the chance to do that. Basketball, it's been a little tough. It's definitely an adjustment, but I'm getting there. It's hard to be away, but and it's a completely different style of game over there. So just it's an adjustment and just making it. But it's still good. We play a lot of good other Americans in the leagues. I'm in a good league, so it's nice.
Now you're playing, tell me where the city is and how much traveling actually is there involved. How often do you play?
Just once a week, so it's a lot of practice.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Holy cow.
I'm in a town called Orvieto. It's an hour from Rome, so it's convenient. It's very central Italy, so it's convenient to go a lot of places. But most teams are northern, so it's usually 4 to 5 hour trips. And we travel on game day, so.
Oh, wow.
Trips
okay.
On game day.
Not like in the United States where you would travel to Richmond
yes.
the night before,
yes.
sleep in a bed UGA, there, and then
yeah.
play Virginia a night before. Yeah, so,
yeah.
okay.
So it's a lot different, but, you know, some closest trips about an hour and a half. Most of them are, there's one team that we would fly to. It's on, like, the island of, I can't pronounce it.
Okay.
So
one of those Mediterranean islands.
Yeah.
Okay. So you were saying that the style is different. What's the biggest difference in the style of what you're playing there as compared to the American collegiate game?
Probably the physicalness. It's not as much raw athleticism and physicalness. It's a lot of craftiness and just more simple game, I guess. There's different calls. Americans get a lot of travel calls over there. You have different movements with traveling, and that's a hard part.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, probably you just don't see that, like, just, you know, raw athleticism over there.
When you were playing here, of course, Greg Warner, your strength and conditioning coach, and I know he got you physically fit to play the collegiate game. Do you still have the same type of training regimen from that perspective?
No. I mean, I do stuff on my own, but the team-wise, no. We don't really lift. Maybe our strength coach will have us lift maybe once. It's not serious at all. Running occasionally. We had a preseason, but it was nothing, like, compared to college, you know. So it's a lot different. So if you lift a lot of places overseas, I know people do it personally on their own. We have weight rooms. So I'll just get it on my own. So it's not as good as G-Dub here, but.
Now, I quite honestly, being neighbors, I've talked to your mom, and I know it's actually been a struggle just because the whole, not necessarily the cultural adjustment, but maybe the basketball cultural adjustment seems to be the biggest struggle for you.
Yeah. It's tough to be away, but you get used to that as time goes on. The basketball, it's very different. It's not like the college at all. It's tough, the team. Just having some Americans, different foreigner than Italians trying to mesh and play. It's tough to come together, different styles.
Are there communication problems?
Yeah, my coach doesn't speak English, so I have one or two teammates that'll help break down stuff, but there's always, just in our last game, there was an error from communication, so.
All righty. Well, Kirby, we're going to wrap it up here. Glad that you can join us. Welcome back. Glad you're here for the holidays. I'll come over and we'll have a Christmas cookie or two here over the next 10 days. How long do you get to stay in the U.S.?
Just a week.
Just
the 30th.
A week. Oh,
yeah.
Wow. So it'll go by much too fast, I'm sure,
yes.
For Kirby. But, well, welcome home. Enjoy. Get a chance to get out and talk to some of the fans here. I know that they're happy that you're back as well. And best of luck as you return over to Italy. And hopefully things will improve for you there on the basketball court. All right.
Thank you.
Very good. That's Kirby Burkholder, former Colonial Athletic Association Player of the Year, and, of course, a star here for Coach Kenny Brooks. We're at halftime. The Dukes, well, they're up 34-28 here at intermission, and we're going to show you some of the highlights of the first half, as well as take a look at our first half statistics here on MadiZone HD SportsNet, which, of course, is presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association, as Norfolk State trailing the Dukes 34-28, JMU shooting 50% in the first half, 12 for 24, 6 of 10 on three-pointers, 60% there. The one area the Dukes did not shoot very well was at the free throw line, going 4 for 9 for 44%. Meanwhile, Norfolk State 11 for 26, that's 42.3%, about what the Spartans typically shoot. 3 of 6 on three-pointers, 3 of 4 at the free throw line. Norfolk State with an advantage on the board of 16-14. For the Spartans, 8 assists, 8 turnovers, 3 blocks, and no steals. For the Dukes, 11 assists, 4 of those by Ron Curry, but he was on the bench for the last 6 minutes because of foul difficulty. He had Joey McLean with the foul situation. McLean whistled for 4 fouls. Curry has 2. 6 turnovers for the Dukes in the first 20 minutes, no blocks, and 6 steals. Points and rebounds in the first half for Norfolk State. Jeff Short with a team-best 10 points, 1 rebound, 6 points and 7 boards for Gaston Fuentes, 1 point, 2 rebounds, 3 assists, and a couple of turnovers in 13 minutes. Deshaun Taylor, 5 points and no rebounds, 10 points on the one board for Short. Also, Robinson, no points, no rebounds. He does have an assist. No points and a rebound for Gray. 4 points, 2 rebounds for Jordan Butler. And Russell has 2 points and 3 rebounds. For the Dukes, Shotkus scored the first 4 points of the ball game for Madison, as he has a rebound. 6 points, 6 boards for Johanny Dallenberg. Curry, 3 points, no rebounds, and 4 assists. 5 points and an assist for Winston Grays. Jackson Kent, a game-high 13, including 3 of 3 on three-pointers. McLean, no points, no rebounds. He does have 3 assists. Nation with a tray and a rebound and 2 rebounds apiece for Hari Hall and Ivan Lukic. Dukes with 10 points in the paint to 14 for Norfolk State. off turnovers. JMU 8, Norfolk State 4. Second chance points, Norfolk State 7. JMU 5, fast break points, Norfolk State 4. JMU zip, and off the bench, Norfolk State was 6, JMU at 3. The score was tied twice, and the lead changed hands 8 times. I think we're doing a photo opportunity now, so excuse us for a moment. All right. Selfies during broadcast, that's right. Dukes led by as many as, let's see here, 10 in the first half. That's when they were up 34-24, and Norfolk State led by no more than 4, and that was in the first minute of the ball game. So it was off to the, that's right, it was 3-2 and then 6-2. And then the lead started to change hands multiple times. A couple of shout outs. Tom, Jennifer, and Sarah Patterson watching down in Roanoke today. So thankful for MadiZone bringing us the Dukes action over the holiday break. Wishing Kurt, Kirby, and everyone there a wonderful holiday season. I'm sure it is going to be a wonderful holiday there in the Patterson household as well. And again, if you'd like to email us here, there's that email address, madizone@jmu.edu. We would love to hear from folks here tonight. And happy holidays to one and all. Again, want to thank Kirby for stopping by. You and Kirby got caught up there for a moment. That's the first time you had a chance to see her since
she
came back.
She got back late on Sunday.
Right.
Yesterday, yeah. So first time I finally got to see her in the past couple of months.
Now her mom and grandmother went over for about a 10-day period. They got to see, I think, may have been 3 games. I wanted to ask her more about some of the, what she considers her best experiences just traveling about. I know she's had some fun, particularly with her American roommate and going about now. But it's work. Really is work.
It definitely is. And I definitely think she's enjoying herself over there. She said she's been able to see a lot of places, sightsee, and just experience a lot of what Italy has to offer her besides just basketball.
Well, the thing is, if she can work this out, now Coach Brooks knows some other folks and certainly some contacts, maybe something will work out just a little better circumstance for her. But you got to start somewhere, so she's starting over there in Italy. We're starting the second half here with the Dukes and the 6-point lead. Taylor missing the long rebound. Coming out short, will track it down. Taylor will hand it off now to Fuentes. He had 1 point off a free throw in the first half. And a few assists. Short goes up and under. He'll draw contact. That should be against Dallenbear, and it is. That's Johanny's first personal foul. And Short goes to the free throw line to shoot 2. He has a game or a team high 11 points now. Jackson Kent with the team high and game high of 13. Second shot also up and in. Short with a couple of points here this half.
Those are his first points, I think, since close to the 10-minute mark of the first half.
Gray steps into a 3-pointer. Off the front of the rim, Short comes down with a rebound. Norfolk State on the run, and that's slammed in by Gaston. He has 8, and it's a 2-point ball game. Diana and Mackenzie Shaw also watching on MadiZone tonight. They say good to see Kirby back at JMU. We miss her. Merry Christmas to the JMU Nation. Winston Graves comes down, misses another shot. Winston's folks are in town this weekend too. They came in for the Saturday-Monday ball games. Baseline jumper is good from Jeff Short. And that is a 3-pointer from the corner. And all of a sudden, the Dukes lead is gone. As we change the lead for the 9th time, Pauly is short, Shotka's a little short and getting too short.
Shorts now shooting 3 from 4 from the three-point line, too. So definitely something to keep an eye out for.
Well, and we saw it, the way that I visualized it in that first half, he was right in front of us. If he's open, he's going to take the three. If you put pressure on him, he has a tendency to go ahead and drive, and he hasn't been as accurate when you do make him put him on the run. Now, he did have a couple of good elevated shots, but I think you want to see him put it on the floor.
Definitely do. Definitely not somebody you can give a wide open 3-2 just like that last possession.
Well, he hit his first two and they were wide open. It left him open in the far corner. And that's the same corner he's good from. He shoots from that left wing. And that's obviously his spot.
3 for 3 from the corner now. Those first two he had were from the corner as well.
Put him and Jackson Kent down there and you can have a 3-point shooting contest. We didn't have, we do not have the full contingent of Pep Band members, but you can't tell by the decibels.
And they still sound just as good. It's so crazy to imagine if the whole group of them were here, how loud it would be in here. And also, a decent turnout for this game tonight with everybody being on break and close to the holiday season.
Well, the weather outside is a little iffy, too. Little concern that if the temperature drops just a few degrees, it could be tough sledding, no pun intended, but actually it was very much intended there. Shotkus, here's Graves. He missed his last 2 3-pointers, so maybe a little more hesitant now. Got to get the feel back. Ron Curry playing in his 75th game tonight for the Dukes, and a foul away from the basketball. Jackson Kent will get, nope, check that. It's going to be Shotkus. That's his first. Ari Hall will come in for Madison. Here's Short on the right wing. They go over the top. And a traveling violation whistled against Gaston. That is the 9th turnover. Shout out to Alex. Says the team is deep this year and can definitely contend for the top spot in the CA. He'll be watching all year long on MadiZone, as always. Thank you for logging on tonight, Alex. We had about 575 or so watching the Dukes and High Point here on Saturday as Hari Hall follows up. Hall getting his first bucket. He averaged 12.5 points and 3.5 rebounds in the Dukes' 2 games this past week, including tying his career high with 15 points. And there's the drive by Short. He's right around his average now. He's got 17. Norfolk State again out in front by 1. Ball knocked away. Jackson Kent will track it down. Kent looking for the screen, gets the double team down low. Nice pass and a foul. Johanny wanted to go up and go up with authority. I think he found himself betwixt and between.
Really nice pass there by Jackson Kent to get it over Gaston for Norfolk State. And you know, just tough break for Johanny not putting the ball in the net.
Thomas, his second personal foul. Let's see if Johanny made the adjustment to shoot free throws, and he has. The Dukes were 4 for 9 at the break on free throws. Norfolk State has played Virginia and Vanderbilt already, and both of those were losses. But after tonight's game, again, this is the first of 6 straight games on the road, they'll face the likes of Baylor and Georgia. Princeton is no slack either. Just a different style. Nice defensive play by Andre Nation. Dukes will come up with the turnover.
Definitely tough there. You're just talking about Norfolk State's schedule so far, and they're only 1-4 on the road, with their overall record being 8-5. So definitely these road games coming up for them will be big games.
Well, they're tough opponents. Obviously, if they come up with a win against Baylor or Georgia, those are upsets. So the key for Norfolk State in those games is not get their head down. And Johanny Dallenberg going up strong again, drawing the foul. This time it's Malik Thomas. That'll be three on him. Curry trying to pick up another assist. He had four in the first half. He's still at four. So Dallenberg. Wasn't pretty, but it counts the same. He can become the second Duke in double figures here with another free throw. Joining Jackson Kent, who's got 17. Now Kent, career high 18. He's hit that twice this year. Longwood and then High Point. And there's point number 10 for Dallenberg.
You mentioned it earlier in the game, how you see sometimes Jackson Kent will really be on fire in the first half and then doesn't produce that much in the second half. So I'll be curious to see what he does here in the second half to get looks at the basket.
Well, he's got four here in the second. Short on the right wing. Haven't seen him shoot from over there yet. Taylor spins against Jackson Kent. Rims the cup. Rebound, Hari Hall. Hall out to Curry. Curry down the floor in a hurry. Looking for the screen. He'll get it. Dallenberg fumbles with it for a moment. Johanny, that's not his shot. And he'll drive and draw contact. Rashid Gaston, his third. So you have Gaston with third. Thomas has his third. Russell has three. So a little bit of an issue now working for the Spartans of Norfolk State. Duke's up 40-37. Back with more after this timeout. You're watching JMU men's basketball tonight here on MadiZone HD SportsNet, presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association.
Instead of asking yourself, where did those 4 years go, think about where the next 40 will take you. Be involved at Madison. Dukes from day one, alumni for life.
40-37, JMU with the lead. Johanny Dallenberg driving. And a foul called on the other end. Robert Jones pleading his case. There's Coach Jones. Give a shout out to Little Miss Washington, Madison Washington, daughter of Tony Washington. Tony was here this weekend. They're watching up in Reston, and Madison wants to say hi, Nikki.
Hello, Madison, and Merry Christmas.
There you go. And Kirby would say the same thing, but she's back up in the stands somewhere. She's out signing autographs. She can do that now and get paid for it if she wants to.
Professional athlete now.
That's right. Well, Duke's missed another opportunity. Score the bucket. And that pass. A little errant. Jamel Fuentes losing the handle. Fuentes averages 5.4 assists per game. He's got four today.
He's the only one from Norfolk State, the starters, out of the five starters they have, who averages single points, 2.9 points a game. And you've seen it a little bit in the first half. He really looks to find his teammates rather than shoot the ball himself.
Ari Hall had an open jumper right there. That's just like a free throw. just not quite stationary. And the free throw line has not been a kind place to the Dukes here this evening. You may want to consider taking that shot from somewhere else. Backdoor cut, nicely done. Short easily lays it in. So he's above his scoring average now at 19.
You just mentioned the free throws for the Dukes, only shooting 8 for 13 right now, 62%, leaving a lot of points left on the free throw line.
Down inside it goes, knocked away, last touched. Gaston. He thought it was last touched by one of the Dukes. Mr. Duda handing the basketball to Nation. Nation to Hari Hall. Hall with the floater, no good. Rebound, Gaston. 17 rebounds for the 16 for the Dukes, 22 now for Norfolk State. Short and an illegal screen applied by Russell as he was moving. Four fouls now on Russell. So he will join Joey McLean with four personal fouls, and right away they'll go to the other big man, Jordan Butler. Butler didn't play a lot of minutes in the first half, but he was influential. He played 7 minutes. Showed some strength.
Butler, a guy who only averages 12 minutes a game for Norfolk State.
...14-12 to go in regulation. I say regulation, Norfolk State has played two overtime games. They're going to try to jump Ron Curry, and it works, and then knocked away by Nation. And Nation will lay it in after Jackson Kent recovers the loose ball.
Good job by the Dukes right there, really to stay after the ball. You saw it rolling around a couple times just to get it up, and Andre Nation with an easy look at the basket.
Foul called on D'Alembert. That's his second.
Replay there, it looked like all ball, but you've seen it a lot tonight that the refs have been calling fouls, and there hasn't been a lot of contact with the fouls that they are calling, which is surprising.
Now, when you were a player, games like this where it seemed very light fouls were being called, I mean, which was more frustrating for you, when you were getting beat to death and no fouls were being called, or when it's just a touch foul being called?
I mean, touch fouls were much more frustrating for me, not necessarily from an offensive perspective, but defensively, because I mean, I was a player who liked to play
right.
defense, so it was definitely always something that was hard to get used to, because it really affects the flow of the game as well. You can't really get in a rhythm when, you know, the refs are calling the game really close like that.
Well, I know that you brought that football mentality to the game.
Kind of hard not to when
That's
you have
right.
a family full of football players.
That's right. Of course, your mother played field hockey and lacrosse, so she was used to contact as well.
She was.
Yeah, Christmas hugs around the Newman household. I can't imagine what they're like. Bounce pass, knocked around. There's Hall getting on the floor. Okay, good hustle there. Now, I'm glad to see Hari Hall get on the floor like that. In the game at Ball State, a couple times, he just like bending over. Let me pick this up. You don't do that, do you, Nikki?
Nope, not at all. Got to get on the floor after loose balls.
I think maybe Coach Brady should employ you to do some floor drills with Hari.
Didn't have a problem with that. It was so funny, you know. I guess I was on the floor so much that they started making me wear knee pads, which
yeah.
I was completely against, but I guess for the long run it was better.
I think so too. You'll be more appreciative of it in about 17 years or so.
Sure I will.
A little jumper elevated by Short. He has 21. Once again, he is into the 20s. He has had a tremendous run of 20-point ball games.
You see Joey McLean back in the game now for the Dukes with four fouls. So it's going to be very important for him on the defensive end just to play smart.
So we got him and Curry. Here's the alley-oop looking for Hall. And I don't know if that was the smart play. Gaston coming up with a steal. 42-41 as we approach the 12-minute mark. You mentioned the pep band coming back, many of them. Same for the cheerleaders. Some of them traveled back in from Richmond today.
Very cool. It's very cool that they, you know, all come back to support us and just the support that JMU Nation gives as a whole.
Duke's up 42-41. Another timeout on the floor. It's a tight one, gang. As we'll come back in just a moment on MadiZone HD SportsNet, presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association.
There's a great place to find high-quality cars without the hassles.
And it all starts here, at CarMax.
We believe that buying a high-quality used car should be hassle-free. So at CarMax, we start with a low, no-haggle price on every car.
With a great selection on every lot, you can test drive an incredible variety of cars all in one place.
And every CarMax car is protected with a 30-day warranty and a 5-day money-back guarantee.
So when you're ready to start the search for your next car, come see the way car buying should be at CarMax. Start here.
And Telos wants to give you more for the holidays, like 2 gigs of data and unlimited talk and text for just $25 a month. That's a better value than Verizon and AT&T. And nothing says happy holidays like getting the smartphone you want for zero down. And Telos will even buy out your contract. It's $25, 2 gigs of data, and unlimited talk and text. Happier holidays from Entelos. More phones, more lines, more data. Get more for the holidays from Entelos.
Well, you can support the JMU student athletes by joining the Duke Club. Call 568-6461. Of course, we're getting towards the end of the year, so if you have yet to make your Duke Club contribution, there still is time to do so that you can get your tax deductible contribution in. Actually, tomorrow the Duke Club will be open, as the doors will be open there from 9 a.m. until 2 p.m. tomorrow. And then they will be closed until New Year's Eve. And on that day, a week from Wednesday, it'll be open from 9 o'clock until 1 o'clock. So if you need to get in your Duke Club contribution, you can do so. You can drop it off, or you can call, or you can go online to do so. And the JMU Athletics Department certainly would appreciate it, as we have a lot of student athletes to support, as the funds from the Duke Club support student athlete scholarships as well as the general athletic operating budget. Stoppage of play on a foul. Ari Hall, that is his first. And Butler will go to the free throw line. Butler gets a favorable roll, puts him at 5 points. That's twice his average.
That's 9 points from the bench for Norfolk State right now, only 7 from JMU. And a semi-low scoring game right now, JMU 42, Norfolk State 43, and majority of those points from Norfolk State are coming from Jeff Short, 21 points right now in the game.
Winston Gray's three-pointer won't fall, but Hari Hall finishes up. Now Hari, this is only his third year of organized basketball.
Started playing as a junior in high school.
Yep. So a lot of upside potential for Hari Hall. He obviously has the athleticism. Much like Johanny D'Alembert hadn't been playing all that long either until he came over from Haiti. Gaston scoring that bucket. That puts him in double figures. He has 10. Jackson Kent stops, pops a little short. And a foul on Jackson going over the top.
Really good move there by Jackson. Just needed to get a little bit more lift on the ball. We'll see here.
Yeah. State with a one-point lead. Working off the foul line, extended. The drive as Fuentes takes it up against McLean. That's his first field goal of the day. He averages 2.9 points, and he's got three. Three points separates the two teams right now. Hall drives, and it is blocked. Back to the wall. Norfolk State on a hot streak here. Seven of the Spartans' last nine shots have fallen. The Dukes, they've missed six of their last eight. Pass comes out to Graves. Hall. Back to Hall again, down low, kicking it back out. Winston Gray. No, that's McLean, rather. Graves will get the rebound, and he'll get the foul also.
Really great inside-outside look there from Yo-Yo out to Joey McLean for the three-pointer. Once again, Gaston there pleading his case to the ref. It seems like he's done that a number of times after a foul call tonight.
Yeah, he is. He must be a political science major. He's been pleading cases a lot tonight. Dukes are having a hard time just buying a basket right now. Nine and a half to go. Gaston out top. Graves, the screen. That's a moving screen on Gaston, and that's four. And there he, Gaston, palms to the sky again. That is his fourth personal foul.
Definitely a player Norfolk State would want on the floor right now for them, averaging 15 points a game, nine rebounds a game, and four fouls with 9 minutes left.
It's also Gaston was the one who was called for the technical for hanging on the rim. So he feels like the basketball world's against him right now. And the fourth foul called on Malik Thomas.
A player for Norfolk State who's kind of been quiet tonight. He comes into the game averaging 11 points a game, and he hasn't put any points on the board for Norfolk State yet tonight.
Kent will go to the stripe. 17. He'll make that 14 points. That's his first point. I said earlier, I was reading the wrong side, I think. Why didn't you correct me then?
Because I wasn't positive.
Okay.
Maybe you saw something. No, I didn't.
Obviously I did, but it was not what I thought I was seeing. Okay, that's his first 2 points here in the second half. I know exactly what I had done. I had thought I was looking up at the scoreboard on the at the top, thinking it was short. Instead, my mental capacity was a little short on that one, so.
Really good defensive play there by Joey McLean. One, not to get a foul call, but also, you know, to get on the floor to try to get after that. And interesting that they gave the timeout to Norfolk State because it didn't look like he had possession of the ball right there.
Got a 30-second timeout on the floor. Eight fifty-six to play, that is, here at the Convocation Center. And there you see the next ball game for the women will be on the road. You're going back to have you been to Nashville before?
I have not been to Nashville.
Ever?
No, never.
Really?
First time.
When are you leaving? Do you know? Sunday?
I believe we are leaving the 28th, yes.
Okay. So going down to Nashville. Are you flying?
I think we're driving as well.
Okay.
It's over break, so.
Yeah, right. No big need to get, it's a little cheaper, obviously, to do that. You'll need a bus when you get there anyway, so. Vanderbilt there in Nashville. As the Dukes, that's a I haven't looked to see how the Commodores are doing. Have you started to get a read on them yet?
A little bit. And they actually just came out and beat Northwestern, a team who was undefeated thus far into the season. But, you know, also looking back to the game last year, came to JMU here at the Combo and won in overtime. So it should be a good game.
That was the last time an opponent won on this floor against the women's basketball Dukes. Foul is whistled against Joey McLean. That's his fifth. So McLean is out of the ball game now for the Dukes. And that comes with 8:41 to go. So Curry will come back in. Matt Brady's had to manage the fouls amongst his point guards. Now, as I was saying earlier, the Dukes were without a second point guard for seven games with McLean on the bench with a foot injury. Looks like he might be banged up a little bit today as trainer's looking at him. Dukes trail by one, staying in contact. Down low and a foul. Vinogradovas will go to the free throw line on the foul from Winston Grays, his second. Out of Lithuania. In and out. He's now 4 for 8 this season. Andre Nation will come back in. Grays will go out. Look at Andre. Listed at 7-1. And the long rebound coming out. Here's Butler, drops it down low. Taylor got loose and counted. He'll get the and one as Jackson Kent late to get there. He'll get whistled for the foul. Norfolk State led by as many as 4 in the first half. And that's their largest lead still. Dukes have led by as many as 10. Dukes have let some double-digit leads get away from them this season. That goes back to what I was saying in the first half about ball tapped out, but controlled by the Dukes, about the Dukes not taking care of opportunities. That ball blocked. I'd like to see that one again on replay. It's Taylor on the drive, bumps, now dumps it off, and the slam. Vinogradovas with the slam, that is. He's got 2. And it's a 5-point lead with 7:49 to go. Timeout for the Dukes. This will be a 30-second timeout.
We've seen Norfolk State be a lot more aggressive on the offensive end here in this, I mean, within the last media that they had.
Here we go with that. Nation going up. That's pretty close. Looked like it might have been at the apex, so it may not have been coming down yet, so no goaltending was called. This is kind of a gut check time now for Madison as the Dukes had the 3-point lead with 6 and some change against High Point here on Saturday. Then the Panthers went on a 10-0 run, put the Dukes too far in a hole, and they ended up losing by 9, 80-71. See how JMU responds today. Foul on the visitors, number 8, and the foul goes against Fuentes. That's just his first, but team foul number 8. So 1-1 for Hari Hall as we return after this timeout. You're watching JMU men's basketball here on MadiZONE HD SportsNet, presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association.
You can't keep putting it off.
Hey, I overheard your other issue. You know we can take care of that too.
You do prostate exams?
Well, yeah, it's the same thing, just for cars. We'll bundle it. It'll be cheaper.
I like cheaper.
Pretty much the same isn't the same.
It's cheaper!
Want the facts? Learn more at thatsthetruth.com.
Here you see that play again with Nation going up. And it was a good block for Rashid Gaston. And it results in another possession. Duke's a bit of a scramble. Left all alone. Vino Grondovas, and he slams it in and celebrates down the court. Come back the other way. The Dukes will have a one-and-one situation. But Hari Hall going to the free throw line. Hari 0 for, well, he hasn't been to the free throw line. He's 2 for 8 from the field, 0 for 1 on three-pointers. But yet to go to the free throw line. There's the little Pierre Curtis.
Pierre is happy about that.
I know he is. Pierre coaching now with Jackie Smith Carson down at Furman. So Pierre, he wore the same purple. He just had to put Paladins on the front instead of Dukes. Hall at the free throw line, gets it to fall in. That's a big one. Why is that a big one? Because he gets another try now. That's 3 points for Hall. Second shot, also good. A little cleaner this time for Hari. He has 4. He is a good free throw shooter, 76%.
18 for 23 on the year now.
Butler, and a short shot, rebound Hall. Hari grabbing his 6th rebound on the night. Foul, a holding call against the Spartans. Pino Gradovas, that's his first. And this will send Shotkus to the free throw line. He scored the first 2 field goals for the Dukes. Did Paulius. Now he's got a chance to cut into the lead a little bit. That's right, it's 2 Pauliuses from Lithuania. Well, actually, yeah, from Lithuania facing one another. One does have a decided height advantage. The Norfolk State Paulius, 7-1. The JMU Paulius, 6-8. And he chucks that one in, 6 points. Dukes down by 1 now, a little 4-point run for the Dukes. Butler gets free.
Butler's
he has 8.
Butler's having a really good game off of the bench for Norfolk State right now.
Yeah, he's bringing good, powerful energy into the game for the Spartans. The Spartans go back to the zone.
It is, especially with Gadsden for Norfolk State on the bench.
Gadsden with 4 fouls. That relegates him to the bench for a while. Here's the alley-oop and a little too far. Ron Curry saying, my fault. Curry with 4 assists early in the game. Could have easily been connected. Not sure what was off on that play. Driving down underneath. Nice pass for Fuentes to pick up his 5th assist. And now Butler's in double figures. His career high is 12. Grays. Lead back out to five. Hall gets a favorable fall. Hari has six. Duke's down by three at the moment. Skip pass right wing. Foul on Grace. That's three on Winston.
I saw Winston getting out there a little bit late on defense, and Short just taking advantage of that.
Short goes to the free throw line. He does have 21 points today.
Short is an 85% free throw shooter, shooting 48 for 56 from the line.
And he's coming off a 25-point game in the win over the Lumberjacks of Northern Arizona. And with him reaching 20 points, it's the ninth straight game in which they've had at least one player with 20 points in a ball game. Dukes work it down. Three-pointer for Curry. Good. And he shot that with about as good authority and confidence as we've seen in a couple of games now.
It's been pretty quiet this whole game so far. Only 6 points now, but definitely a big-time shot.
Dukes will need a couple more big-time shots. Get over the hump of the Spartans here. Norfolk State looking to get a road win. Only 1-4 on the road. Turned by Taylor and a foul. There's one of those touch fouls you were talking about, Nikki.
Definitely a very interesting call and a tough break for JMU as well, because he was fouled on the three-point shot. So going to the line for three easy, uncontested shots now.
Well, there was some contact there, a little more than I thought, but wow. I guess it was just so out there in the open, and Billy Hume's right there.
It's also interesting, too, because you saw there on the replay, it looked like he fouled him, if anything, before he even got the shot off. So
yeah, it was
interesting
down,
that
was,
they called on the shot.
Yeah, right there at about belt level. And now I think what they're going to do is see if it was in three-point territory, whether they should give him two or three on the play. What did we see? No, we're screened out. We couldn't tell. Here's another angle. That looks like, again, I don't know that we would have it's inconclusive to us because we can't see it.
Very true.
The finish. We can only assume. There's the shot we need to see. Yep, definitely. All right. That's conclusive.
That would be conclusive, yes.
Right. Make that Taylor at the line. He's got six. All right. One out of two. And we're going to see, is that Gaston coming back in? It is. So Gaston is back in. Thomas back in. Robinson back in. Three-point lead, so he goes 2 for 3, does Taylor. Taylor with 9. Duke's down by 4 with 4:44 to go. Jackson Kent. Wide open D'Alembert, ball knocked away, however. Dukes just don't handle it. Yohani seems to be a step slow tonight in his reaction.
He has been, especially here in this second half. In the first half, he wasn't that bad, but definitely hasn't seemed to get in a rhythm in the second half.
A charge called against Short. It's his second personal foul. Shotkus will come back in. He'll come in for Hari Hall.
You almost have to wonder if that foul there on Short was a makeup call from the last one that they called.
Skipping the pass over, three-pointer by Jackson Kent. Rattles in and out, rebound Paulus. Three-point try, that to Curry. Rebound comes down to Robinson, he'll run the floor. Taylor will toss it up, he'll get fouled. D'Alembert the foul. That's three on Yo-Yo. And that brings us to 3:34 in our final media timeout. Duke still down by four, 59-55. Back with the final 3:34 after this timeout. You're watching JMU Men's Basketball this evening on MadiZone HD SportsNet. It's presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association.
Virginia Business Systems delivers fast-forward document solutions to help JMU Athletics build the teams they need to win. With over 7 offices and over 70 employees in Virginia, we strive to deliver the best in digital document technology. VBS Innovation takes our clients to new levels. But we're not just a proud supporter, we're also a Duke Club member, and we're owned by 2 JMU alums. Go Virginia Business Systems!
This is the last game for both the men and women's basketball Dukes through Christmas, and then both teams will get back on the floor next week. Nick and I are talking about the women going to Nashville to face Vanderbilt, the Commodores. The men will be here facing Valparaiso. Last time I checked, Valpo was 10-2. That was coming off a win against Ball State. And that on Monday, then the rest of the week will be quiet. We'll get back into really the thick of things. We'll have games on Saturdays and Monday. Actually, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Three of those four will be here.
And that's a string of the first conference games to begin as well.
Yep, sure is. Taylor at the free throw line for 10. Yep, the men open up against Towson on Saturday. The women face Towson on Sunday. Taylor hits them both. It's now a 61-55 score. Then the men go to the College of Charleston, and the women will be home on Tuesday against UNC Wilmington. Beyond that, I'm just thinking about getting to that Tuesday.
That's pretty good, so I won't judge you after that.
I think the Dukes, the men, are here on that Thursday against Northeastern. I think that's right. There's D'Alembert with the big bucket.
Really important defense, and a foul, but really important for the Dukes to play good defense here for the next 3 minutes. And tough break there, but they're really going to have to get it down on the defensive end.
That's on Jackson Kent. That's four now on Jackson. See, his family is here again tonight. Jackson celebrating a birthday on Saturday. Short with 24 points now. He's averaged 21 in the last 8 games. Now 25, so back-to-back 25-point games for Jeff Short. Out of the Bronx, New York. Nation cut off at the baseline. Curry, ball is deflected. Rebound by Dallin Barron. Score it. He'll get the and one. Fuentes, his second foul. And that'll send Dallin Barron to the free throw line. Yohani with 14. Has a chance to pull the Dukes within a possession. Oh, in and out. Wow. 2:36 to go. Nation working against Short. This is Florida versus New York right here. Andre. The double team. Fuentes gets through it. Short will drive. Good defense for the Dukes, particularly under the scramble situation. Down low. Curry jumps in there. Timeout call by the Dukes. They were going to get the possession with the arrow, but weren't sure. What happened here? Did we get a technical? I heard a late whistle. Let's see what we've got here. Billy Humes trying to sort things out now. Well, let's see what we've got. All right, so you see the hustle play by Curry. All right, and then Gaston, he must have come up with the vocal no-no.
I believe he did, and that'll be on the fifth on Gaston, so yep. He'll be out for the game.
So Gaston is out of the game, and this will bring the Serbian back, or the Lithuanian back in, excuse me. Vino Gradovis will come back in. As Gaston will foul out with 2:06 to go. See it there. Wow, Billy Humes was quicker than I think the official that was closest to him, because he just didn't have, he was about to signal what the foul was. He didn't have the whistle in the right position. So Humes, obviously both officials heard whatever it was that was stated.
You could see there too the frustration on Norfolk State's coach Robert Jones with Gaston picking up his fifth.
Six to go. Let's see how this will work out now. Jackson Kent will take the free throws. Kent, 6 for 6 at the stripe tonight. Okay, 15 points. I do have that right, don't I? 16 points.
And I guess I did just realize this. The Dukes have possession of
the ball.
They'll
get possession as well. That's right. So a big swing of events here if the Dukes can capitalize, particularly on this possession.
Opportunity to either tie it up, even take the lead.
Curry's just going to let the ball roll across midcourt. Curry again playing in his 75th game as a Duke. The alley-oop try stolen away. That was read well by Butler.
It's a really tough pass there by Ron Curry to try to get the alley-oop to Andre Nation, especially in a situation like this, under 2 minutes, down by 2 points.
Butler passing it off right wing. Fuentes. Taylor will drive, cut off by two Dukes. Shot clock down to 12. Short will drive and a foul on Nation. That's his first personal foul. So if the Dukes need to give fouls, Andre can give them and stay in the game with 1:32 to go, and Short going to the line.
I'm not necessarily sure that Short is the one you want to be fouling,
no.
But at the same time, the way the refs have been calling the game, it's kind of hard to tell how to play defense, and just something that the Dukes haven't adjusted to.
Thomas back in. Short back to the line. Three-point game. Two-possession game after hitting that free throw. Short now with 27. Kent. Curry will drive. He'll get fouled out front to kick by Fuentes. That's three on him. 1:20 to go, and that will stop the clock and put Curry at the free throw line. Both teams in the double bonus now.
Ron Curry, a 64% free throw shooter, and the opportunity to make this a one possession game again.
Curry has seven, five assists, only one here in the second half. Kent has four assists. He had five against High Point at High Point last year as a freshman. Curry hits them both. 8 points now for Ron. Ball fumbled. Jordan picks it up. Dukes nearly had a steal there. 1:11 to go. The crowd that is here today should get into this now to give the Dukes a six-man defensively. Thomas, right side Fuentes. Here comes Short. It's alone out here with Winston Graves on him. The screen. Short comes up, elevates. That's off the mark. Rebound, Johanny D'Alembert. D'Alembert with his eighth rebound of the game. And the Dukes with a chance to tie it up now. And the Dukes will use a timeout. That is the final timeout for Madison. Norfolk State has two timeouts. Matt Brady told me today that he had concerns with this game. He wanted it to be on the positive side so he would have a Merry Christmas.
Definitely want to go home on Christmas break with a win in your pocket. Never a good feeling going home with a loss. And, you know, you have to wait such a long time to get back into the swing of things and play another game to get that feeling out of your mouth.
Well, and that's what he was saying, that I'd have to wait until, you know, next Monday again to have another chance at it. I'm sure the Brady boys that are sitting up over our left shoulder would have a better Christmas too.
I'm sure they would.
Are the Newmans sticking around Harrisonburg for Christmas?
We will be. Staying around here, and then the rest of the family is headed up north to see some other people after Christmas.
All right, 39 seconds to go. 26 on the shot clock, as you can see. Andre Nation and Ron Curry. Curry to Winston Graves. Nation loses the handle, finds Curry. Shot clock down to a dozen. Curry will drive, stops, pops, count it. Curry has 10, 18 seconds to go. Tie ball game. Short will dribble over and call timeout.
Really smart play there by Ron Curry, you know, not to go right up away with the drive he had and kind of hesitate and then go up with the second for an open jump shot.
Created some space for him as he penetrated into the lane. Here you see, gets a little bit of a shoulder into Short. Short backs off, and that's when Curry. Actually, that goes back to Ron's early career type of shot that he would hit more often. I mean, that was kind of the shot he would teardrop it a lot of times. Now that was a little more guided with the two hands. As he does tie it up, we've had a boatload of ties in today's game. Actually, more lead changes than ties. 15 lead changes at the last timeout, so that still would be accurate as the Dukes have been chasing the Spartans for much of this second half. As long as you catch them at the end.
Very important coming out of this timeout defensively for the Dukes not to foul, especially with Norfolk State being in the double bonus situation and just with the way the refs have been calling the game, it's very important to play solid, smart defense.
Got an email from one of our viewers. Hey guys, once again, thanks for the feed. All I want for Christmas is 89% free throw shooting. 100 would be just greedy. Stifling defense. Andre Nation at point guard and a CAA title. That's Kent in Richmond, Virginia. Tell you what, right now I'd just put a W in the stocking at the mantle and be happy with it.
Be very nice.
I don't care how good the free throw shooting is.
I'm sure at this point that's what the Dukes want as well.
Of course, the Spartans want the same thing, as do the Spartan fans that may be watching here today. Here's the inbounds. Maybe timeout taken again. That'll be the final timeout for Norfolk State. All right. 13 seconds to play. Again, the Spartans have gone into overtime twice. They did so against St. Francis of Brooklyn. They won that one 72-70 and then lost to Mount St. Mary's up in Emmitsburg, Maryland, about 2 hours from here, 67-64 in overtime. That was a couple of Saturdays ago. And that was the same afternoon that the Dukes, or same day the Dukes are playing at East Carolina. Fans are on their feet here at the Convocation Center. This time Short will inbound it. Go into the backcourt. Fuentes. Short, long three-pointer is well short. Rebound Fuentes, he throws it out. Nation, that will not go. It would not count had it gone in, and we have overtime.
You know, hats off to the pep band on that one, calling down the shot clock before it was. And you could definitely see the frustration out of Norfolk State's head coach with Short taking that shot with still 4 seconds left on the shot clock.
He was way out there, just contested enough by Grays. Dukes were fortunate also in the scramble. There wasn't an open man just to hand the ball to underneath as we watch the whole sequence again. Nation denying. Short may have been a little too impatient with it. And Andre, he had no idea how much time left there was, whether he could set and shoot or just toss it up and keep his fingers crossed. So a little bonus basketball for you. Ah, it's the holidays. Why not?
Exactly. Now, another thing to look out for is going into this overtime period, Norfolk State is going to be playing without one of their top scorers, Rasheed Gaston. He fouled out with about 2 minutes left. Two technicals on the night, three personal fouls.
The Dukes have not played any overtime games this season. Norfolk State has the experience with two others. Opening tap won by the Dukes. Shotkus pounds it into the court and comes away with it. Jackson Kent missing. Tossing it out. Turnover by Norfolk State. The Dukes will go to the free throw line. It'll be Andre Nation going out as Fuentes as his fourth personal, and he's a key one too. He's a primary ball handler. So Nation will go to the free throw line. There's the first one for Andre. 6 points. Seven. 7 points for Andre Nation. The Dukes have their first lead in quite some time. When was the last time the Dukes led, Amy? Up there at last time was at 44-43 with 11:31 to go. Short, looked like he walks. Ball knocked out of the hands of Short. Inbounds comes out to Fuentes. 15 on the shot clock now. Short, three-pointer. Nope, he's going to drive and scoops it up. Short with 29. We're tied once again at 67. Last time the Dukes played an overtime game was beating Drexel 63-61 here at home last year. Last February, actually, February 19th. Elevating. Nation missing. Taylor with the rebound. Both teams with a field goal here in this overtime period. Fuentes now playing with four fouls. Thomas will try a three, and he counts it.
It's actually Thomas's first points of the game as well. Somebody who averages 11 points a game.
He is good for three-pointers, though. He's a 33% shooter from the range. Curry will try a three. There you go. And we're tied at 70. Fuentes being guarded by Curry. Short, the left side. That's where he's most dangerous, although he's going to Curry is going to get called for the foul. As I say, he's most dangerous on the left wing. He's proven to be dangerous from all points on the floor now.
He really has. You talked about it earlier. If he doesn't have that three ball that's open, you see him a lot of times drive to the basket.
Let's see that again. Can we roll it up one more time? Let me watch it again. Here we go. Where's Curry? He tripped on his own feet. He fell on his own. That's twice today the Dukes have been called for fouls because of not-so-athletic plays on the other side.
If anything, in that situation, it looked like it could have been a foul on Paulus. He kind of leaned over a little bit, if anything. I definitely don't think it was on Ron Curry.
Curry, another three-point try. Off the iron, rebound. Dalibert tips it out. Fuentes comes up with it. Curry has to be careful. Thomas blocked by Dalibert. And the Dukes will get the basketball. Dukes will start the offense out high. Nation. Kent surveying, Shotkus, right wing, Nation. Wrap around to Dalibert, blocked. Dalibert gets it back, goes up again, blocked again. Great defensive stand there by Norfolk State. Short will try to give it up to Thomas, and they do. Thomas in the corner, or Short rather in the corner now. Shotkus was there that time. 1:45 to go, Fuentes. Jackson Kent harassing Short. Right side, Thomas. Curry on him, the screen. Shot clock down to seven. Fuentes will drive, spins. Out to Thomas. He loses the handle. Shot clock at two. Shot clock violation. Dukes will get the basketball. Good sequence defensively for the Dukes, as there's a lot of activity going on there. That's a nice block by D'Alembert.
You see there, really good drive by Andre Nation on the baseline, getting it to Yohani. Just went up a little bit slow and had his shot blocked.
Yeah, Norfolk State, two great blocks down. Keep the lead in their favor for the Spartans. Curry, down and low it goes, and a foul called against Thomas. That's five on Malik Thomas, I do believe. He's the second Spartan to go down disqualified in this game. Latre Russell will come in. I do believe Jones wants to, Coach Jones wants to take the timeout, or the time to bring in a sub as a timeout, so to speak. With 1 minute to go. So Latre Russell does come in. D'Alembert will go to the free throw line. Give a shout out to Kat Maniantakis. She was here for our doubleheader on Saturday. She's gone back home. D'Alembert can't hit. Yo-Yo with the one dribble, second shot, made the adjustment, rolls in. Took a little off of it. He has 15, does Yohani. His career high is 20. That came earlier this season. And the win over Colgate, the Raiders. Short. Cuts through. Dukes anticipate well. Hand off, Fuentes. Down to 15, the shot clock. Fuentes. Right side, here's Short. Shot clock down to five. Fuentes drives, puts it up and scores the bucket. 27.1 seconds to go. And timeout called.
Norfolk State showed a lot of patience there in that possession, especially with the shot clock running down, to be able to get a look like that at the basket.
Fuentes with five. A timeout called by Norfolk State. All right, Nikki, twice the Dukes have tried to go with the little alley-oop. Twice Norfolk State has been right there. Can you do anything to try to create some space, knowing that they might anticipate that type of play again?
It'll be very interesting. You know, throughout the game, a lot of times you've seen when the Dukes have gotten the ball at the high post, they've had a lot of options, whether it's been a kick out or a drop down to the low post. So it'll definitely be interesting to see what the Dukes do here.
Shot clock is off. Dukes down by two. Jackson Kent, your three-point shooter. Winston Grays. Winston just has one tray today. And Ron Curry with the basketball in his hands, the junior. Out it comes to Winston Grays. Grays will drive. Up and under, takes the shot. Won't go. Rebound, Fuentes, and a foul on Grays. Fuentes will go to the free throw line. 9.6 seconds to go. And Norfolk State in position to win this ball game.
Really not a bad look. I mean, can't get much of a better look than that. An open little jump shot right there. Just a matter of knocking it down for Winston Grays.
Fuentes will shoot two. First one is off. All right, there's still a chance.
Duke still have one timeout as well, so be curious to see if Matt Brady uses that, whether he makes this or misses it.
Dukes are 1-for-5 from the field here in this overtime period. He makes the second. That relegates the Dukes to needing a three. Need a three to tie. Curry. Timeout called with 6 seconds to go. Ron looked like he was about ready to come around the turn and take a shot, did he not?
He definitely did, and just a matter of whether or not the players knew that they had another timeout left, and I'm a little bit surprised that they didn't call the timeout a little bit sooner once they got across half court.
Virginia Tech beats VMI tonight, 87 to 74. Some other scores from around the CAA this evening. Earlier, we told you Elon beat Kennesaw State in an afternoon game, 67-65. Robert Morris, looks like they've defeated Delaware. It says the end of the second. Well, that would be the end of the game, right? 84-81. Delaware scoring some points now, but just not enough. Now the other games, Old Dominion beats William & Mary 69-62. Back here, the inbounds goes into Curry with 6 seconds to go. Curry to Nation three-pointer, off the mark, and Norfolk State will have a Merry Christmas as the Spartans defeat the Dukes 74-71 in the third meeting all time between the programs. And Norfolk State comes in and defeats the Dukes by the three-point margin. JMU misses five of its last six shots, six of its last eight shots, as Norfolk State comes up with a win. Here's a look at it again. Curry double-teamed, took a look, had Nation. Nation takes the shot, a little too strong, and the clock expires. So the Dukes go into the holiday break with the loss, 74-71. Back-to-back home defeats for the Dukes, leaving them now at 7-5. And Norfolk State improves to 9-5 on the season. We'll be back and take a look at our statistics. We'll rewind some of the action in today's ball game. Here courtside from the Convocation Center, as you're watching JMU men's basketball tonight on MadiZONE HD SportsNet, presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association.
Is he still in there?
Yeah.
Sleeping in the closet every single night. This has got to stop.
Oh, hey, Elaine. How's it going?
How much longer are you going to be here?
Billy is five.
Six.
12 years. But don't worry about me. I got my pillow pet.
Tame the tuition monster. Visit Virginia529.com and see why it's the nation's largest 529 college savings plan.
Hey, who wants popcorn?
The Residence Inn by Marriott provides guests with plenty of room. Room to recharge. Room to prepare. Room to relax. Stay one night or as long as you like. The Residence Inn by Marriott provides each guest with amenities tailored to their individual needs. Spacious suites with all the comforts of home. Because it's not just a room, it's a residence.
Welcome back to the JMU Convocation Center. Kurt Dudley and Nikki Newman with you here this evening as the Dukes, they do come up shy against the Spartans of Norfolk State. We'll take a look at our statistics for this evening's ball game. Norfolk State ended up shooting 52.1%, 25 of 48, 5 of 12 on three-pointers, 42%, 19 of 28 at the free throw line, 68% there. The Dukes ended up 36.8%, so the visitors come in and shoot much better on the different on the visiting court. 21 of 57 for the Dukes, 36.8%. 8 of 22 on three-pointers, 36%. So the Dukes take 52 three-pointers in the last two ball games, and they hit 18 of those. JMU at the free throw line, 21 of 28. 75%, and there were points of this game, and the Dukes left some other points out there, missing some one-on-one opportunities. in the paint. Norfolk State 36-24, the advantage there. Off turnovers, JMU did have the lead there, 21-12. Second chance points, Norfolk State 13-11. Fast break, Norfolk State 6-0. And on the bench, JMU 15, outscoring Norfolk State with 14. Score was tied 8 times. The lead changed hands on 17 occasions. And the Dukes, they had their lead, last lead with about 11 minutes to play in the second half. Norfolk State took the lead, and JMU tied it up at the end on the Ron Curry short jumper to send it into overtime. But in the overtime period, the Dukes are outscored 9-6. Norfolk State puts 4 players in double figures. That's what they've done all season. As we'll see, Malik Thomas finishes 3 points, 3 assists. Rasheed Gaston, 10 points, 12 rebounds for the double-double in 27 minutes. He also had a steal. Fuentes with 7 assists, 3 turnovers, 6 points, and 7 boards. Deshaun Taylor, 11 points and a rebound. Jeff Short finishes with 30 points and 8 boards. Not a bad night. Robinson, no points and a rebound. He did have 1 assist. Gray with 1 point, 1 rebound. Vino Gradovas, he finishes with 2 points, no rebounds. Jordan Butler off the bench, 10 points and 4 rebounds. He gave them quite a bit of spark there. And Latrey Russell, 2 points and 3 rebounds for the Dukes. Paulie Ashotka, 6 points, 4 rebounds. Yohani D'Alembert, 15 points, 9 boards for Yohani. Let me see, and Yohani, career high for rebounds is 13. That was against Delaware last February. So he finishes with 9 here tonight. Ron Curry, 13 points and a rebound, 5 assists, 2 turnovers, 1 steal. He played 31 minutes. He was limited in that first half because of 2 fouls. Winston Graves, 5 points and a rebound. Jackson Kent, 17 points, a rebound. He had 4 points in the second half. So I was right, Nikki.
You are?
Just not at the time. Joey McLean, no points, no rebounds, and 3 assists for Joey. He had 2 turnovers. Andre Nation, 7 points, 2 rebounds. Hari Hall, 8 and 6. And Ivan Lukic, no points, 2 rebounds. Largest lead of the ball game for JMU was 10 points. They led it 34-24, but Norfolk State cut into that lead before halftime. Dukes were up by 6, 34-28, but that lead was wiped out early in the second half. It went back and forth again, 17 lead changes. Norfolk State outscoring the Dukes in the second half, 37-31, going into the overtime period, and 9-6 the overtime scoring. McLean fouled out for the Dukes with 8:41 to go. Gaston for Norfolk State, 2:06. Thomas for Norfolk State with 1 minute to play. Attendance tonight, 2,864 here at the Convocation Center. Norfolk State 9-5, JMU 7-5, as Norfolk State wins for the first time in 3 tries against the Dukes of James Madison. We'll come back and wrap this one up from the Convocation Center after this final timeout as you're watching JMU men's basketball on MadiZone HD SportsNet, presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association.
My experience with Glenn and May was amazing.
Our agent was very helpful through the whole process.
There was investment into our interest, more so than just trying to quickly get to a sale.
You know, he's not only my agent, but my friend.
I felt very much like family. Really was very well taken care of and very, very pleased with the entire experience.
Welcome back to the JMU Convocation Center. As a quiet convo right now, the fans have headed out for the final game before Christmas as the Dukes, 74-71, kind of feel like they have a lump of coal in their stocking right now after today's setback. And, Nikki, as you look back at this ball game, uphill climb for the Dukes. They did get to the plateau, but then slipped right back down there in the overtime period.
And they did. They're in the first half, went up by 10, and just had that chance to go up by even more to extend that lead, and came out in the second half not as energetic, it seemed like. You know, they weren't crashing the boards like they did in the first half, and, you know, in the long run, it just ended up hurting them.
There you see the upcoming schedule for the Dukes. They will take a bit of a break now. Not sure when Coach Brady will have them coming back to the convo. He may have given them through Friday off, but after tonight's loss, he may say, well, come back Christmas night. You never know what they're going to do.
Bring him back a little bit earlier.
A little earlier, maybe get in another practice or so. But the Dukes, they have a big challenge. As quite frankly, as I looked at this schedule, I knew High Point was going to be a pretty good team coming in here. Norfolk State, one of its best teams, I think, just looking at it from the early going. As like I said, like we chatted, the eye test looked like a pretty good club, and they certainly have some holes, but they're going to win some games in the MEAC and do pretty well. They've already got the nine victories on the season. But the team that I was, you know, looking at that could snap the streak was actually Valparaiso. Really, of the all the non-conference teams, with the exception of Virginia, Valpo is probably the best program all in all coming in. So that'll be on Monday, December the 29th. Game time is 7 o'clock, and pregame coverage will begin right here at 6:50, and then the Dukes, they'll hit the road. Well, they'll have Towson here to open up. So you see, our next video broadcast is next Monday night, 6:50, the pregame show, the Dukes and the Crusaders of Valparaiso, Valpo as they call themselves, and they're from Valparaiso, Indiana, just a little south of Gary, Indiana. Nikki, that'll kind of do it here.
Sounds good.
Merry Christmas to you and your family.
This should
be a very special. You guys have a lot to be thankful for and a lot to enjoy here. The Newman family, we're glad everybody's healthy and doing well. So,
Thanks very much.
And thank you again for joining us here tonight. And have a fun trip down to Nashville.
I will try. I'm looking forward to it. Never been to Nashville, so it should be a good time.
Interesting court down there.
I've seen.
You'll be looking up at knees everywhere. So that's one of those sunken sidelines, raised courts, if you would, there at Vanderbilt. Some folks that we'd like to thank that helped to bring you the game here this evening on MadiZone HD SportsNet. First of all, for the fine notes from the Spartans of Norfolk State, the basketball SID there for the men's program, Mike Bellow. Of course, here at James Madison to Chris Brooks. I want to thank JMU Assistant Athletics Director John Martin for all of his behind-the-scene work. Our executive producer, John Salem. Director tonight was Taylor Mickleberry. And we also want to thank the rest of the staff from Telemedia Productions. Also thanks to Amy Spring, our courtside director here as well, and for her research aspects for us. Also want to thank all of our sponsors as tonight's game presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association, Virginia Lottery, CarMax, Delta Dental, the JMU Graduate School, Intellos Wireless, Old Dominion Realty, Quaker Steak and Lube, Residence Inn, University Outpost, Virginia Blood Services, Virginia 529, Wells Fargo, the JMU Adult Degree Program, Blue Ridge Power Sports, the JMU Bookstore, Klein May Realty, Pepsi, Virginia Business Systems, Comcast SportsNet, and the JMU Duke Club. So for Nikki Newman and Amy Spring, I'm Kurt Dudley. Once again, our final score tonight in overtime, Norfolk State defeats the Dukes of James Madison 74-71. Good night from the JMU Convocation Center. This has been a MadiZone HD SportsNet production presented to you by the JMU Alumni Association. On behalf of everyone associated with the JMU Alumni Association and JMU Athletics, have a very happy and safe Merry Christmas, everyone, and a Happy New Year.